After starting with a slinky, Allie, Cannan, and Jesse are still on track to confirm the myth that a car can be briefly induced to hover.
Look at levitate.
Oh, it stayed in the air.
But it's one heck of a stretch from a 12-pound bowling ball to a 3,000-pound automobile.
Today is a crazy day. We're literally dropping a car from a crane. I'm excited. I can't wait.
Scaling way up from those elastomer strips, they've sourced a giant bungee, custom made from multiple strips of raw rubber. Given that this rubber has a capacity to stretch 400%,
it just keeps going.
They've decided that suspending the car from the crane 10 feet off the ground requires a 12-foot-long bungee. With preparations complete...
You guys ready?
Yes.
Here we go. We're driving.
Okay.
The first step is to carefully fit the car...
Perfect! Right there!
...into a hefty sling for hoisting.
We'll give it a slight lift so we can figure out the center of gravity, but then it's going to be time to attach the bungee. And that's when it's going to get epic.
Nice!
We bring you the sine wave.
This is a seriously big-scale experiment. So Adam's unearthed some hardcore hardware.
This right here is the famous MythBusters 10,000-pound quick release. We've been using this thing for almost 15 years. It is activated by this pneumatic cylinder, which gets its air from this pneumatic tank, setting off this quick release and letting this car supposedly hover in midair for a few hundred milliseconds.
But first, they have to get it off the ground. The massive bungee stretches and stretches.
It's still going.
For a while, there's serious doubt it will actually lift the car.
We have liftoff.
Oh my goodness.
That's crazy.
I thought we were in trouble there for a second, but we're fine.
That's a lot of stretch on that thing.
Finally, they're ready to test if a car, without added weight, can defy gravity.
Cannan, arm it. The rig is armed. All right, Jesse.
Gravity-defying car with bungee in 3, 2, 1.
That was pretty cool.
That was awesome.
Oh, my goodness.
But.
I don't think that levitated.
You don't think at all?
We'll have to look at the high speed, I guess, but I didn't really see anything the first time.
Couldn't see a darn thing either.
The car's a write-off. But what about the myth? Well, the high speed has the answer. They've done it.
That's 476 frames, which is 95.2 milliseconds.
That's not very long, but that's still pretty cool.
And there's every chance there's something cooler to come, because this is a two-part grand finale.
You know what's better than dropping a car? Dropping a car twice, which is what we're about to do. In all of the scale testing, the MythBusters kept determining that the hover time could be increased by putting an equivalent weight to the payload at the top of the stretchy medium they were experimenting with. And that is exactly what I'm sitting on, a vessel of water equivalent in weight to the car behind me. We're gonna put this at the top of the bungee with the car at the bottom and see if we can increase the gravity-defying properties of that car. Stop. All right, this is the final hookup. You can start to go up, Nick.
Again, the delicate lift proceeds at a snail's pace to hopefully avoid snapping the bungee.
This is what flying cars will look like in the future.
And the team has stretched an unlikely physics phenomenon to the limit. And whether it hovers or not, they're all keyed up for a smashing finale.
This is for the glory. It's even better than last time.
Car bungee test with weight, final test in 3, 2, 1. Did it work?
No.
That's awkward.
What did I do?
That's 6 tons dangling midair. And the very real chance it could all come crashing down at any second.
What we found is we think that the safety pin didn't fully come out, or the electronics at the top haven't been working. Either way, we'll figure something out to get this down, I hope.
This still has no safety on it.
The car and tank are lowered inch by precarious inch until Adam can safely assess and repair.
Stop! We had a failure of the rig in midair, which was pretty scary because this weighs several thousand pounds, and so does that. We isolated the problem to an air leak, which no longer exists, and we should be able to drop a car soon.
With the fault found and rectified.
All right, Nick, up just a little bit.
The double load is once again lifted into position.
That looks lovely. All right, guys, are you ready?
Yes.
Ready.
Oh. All right, Cannan, arm.
Commence primary ignition.
Allie, call it in.
Bungee test with two weights. Final test in 3, 2, 1. That was amazing.
That was a huge explosion, and it just completely chopped the car in half.
Oh, yeah.
That was so much fun.
You could just see like a cascade of the water just flowing out.
But the naked eye can't tell if the car and tank hovered. So it's off to the high speed.
That car is
the
definitely...
The car is still levitating.
That's definitely levitating.
This car is definitely defying gravity right now.
Question is, did it hover any longer than the car by itself?
The second drop was 732 frames, so that's 146.4 milliseconds.
That's a lot better than the last one.
It sure is. The car alone resisted the pull of gravity for 95 milliseconds. And the car with its equivalent weight in water, 146 milliseconds. It's an all-round success. They've proved again that adding and distributing weight actually amounts to more hover time.
Well, I'm not really good with math, but we just crushed a car.
We totally just crushed a car.